Official figures published on Saturday by the National Bureau of Statistics indicates that Nigeria has entered its second recession in 5 years. The figures further reveal that the economy shrank again in the third quarter of this year. It was gathered that this year's recession, occasioned by the economic fallout of the COVID-19 pandemic, is worse than that of 2016. The NBS, in its gross domestic product report of the third quarter, said the GDP, the broadest measure of economic prosperity, fell by 3.62% in the 3 months to September. Economists consider two consecutive quarters of shrinking GDP as the technical definition of a recession. The economy, which emerged from its first recession in 25 years in the second quarter of 2017, when it posted a 0.7% growth, had continued its slow recovery since then. But the COVID-19 crisis made things even worse. We now have Mukhtar Mohammed, who is a financial analyst, to help us make sense of all of this. Good to have you, Mr. Mukhtar.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. Now, the last time we heard about recession, it was caused by the drop in crude. This time, it's blamed on COVID-19. Does this suggest that in every major crisis, we should expect a recession?
No, definitely not. We've had major crises before without getting to recession. And now it's not only the challenge with this recession, that's why it's bigger than the former one, is because we have two things coming together. It's not just the COVID-19. You know, there was a drop in oil price. Also, we have the challenge that has to do with the Forex and the exchange rate. So it's combined. That's why you're saying that it's the worst recession we've had in 25 years, because we are having two very, very challenging situations coming together. So it's not just the COVID-19 alone that is causing the recession we are having now. Both COVID-19, then there's drastic fall in oil price also is one of the cause for the current recession that we are having.
I mean, in the spirit of looking for solution, what can we do differently to come out of this as fast as possible?
Economics recession is not fixed immediately. It has to take time. It has to take a lot of time. So you don't just wake up in the morning and say, oh, finally, we are there. No. You have to put processes in place. Just like it didn't just come overnight, so it will not be sorted out overnight. Now, let's look at it this way. If you look at that figure by the third quarter, if you compare the second quarter to the third quarter, you realize that there's a lot of economic activity that have opened up in this third quarter that made the recession not as worse as we thought. Remember, World Bank was projecting about 4.2 and we are in 3.62. So there seems to be light at the end of the tunnel when you look at those figures by the other previous figures. So what would we have to do? The government is already doing what they think they should do, try to guide the economy back, monetary policy, both monetary and fiscal policy coming together, government interventions in COVID-affected business. But again, the challenge was that it got worse because of the SARS and SARS protests also contributed to the type of recession we are seeing also, because that does not help us to recover very soon. But definitely, I believe with what the figure I saw in the third quarter, we have about 18 places, 18 businesses, 18 sectors that were negative in the second quarter. Those sectors were positive in the third quarter. So we'll see that play out in the fourth quarter. I'm sure by the end of the first quarter of next year, hopefully, at worst, by second quarter of next year, I think Nigeria will be finally out of recession. We've gone through this before, and I think we'll definitely still through it again.
All right, before I let you go now, how do we build, I know you're talking about a solution, but how do we build buffers against recession during crisis of this nature?
The best buffer to build against recession is to have multiple stream of income as a nation. Unfortunately, we are only depending on one stream of income, which is oil. So the best means to beautify, diversify your economy, not only diversify your economy, diversify your revenue. And that we've been able to diversify our revenue, get more people into the tax bracket, more people are paying taxes now. So we need to begin to see how we can diversify our economy. Mm-hmm. Once we diversify our economy, then we'll begin to invest in other areas. Now, the challenge is once food price goes down, then caught by the pandemic, our economy is in recession. It doesn't matter whether it happened during the pandemic or out of the pandemic. It's just because the pandemic resulted in a lot of business closing down. Even without the pandemic, we would have had a very slow growth in the economy because of the falling price of crude. So we need to think of diversifying our economy, going into other sectors. But the challenge is that you don't diversify your economy without using the mainstream of your economy to get into the other stream of your economy. So that is the challenge we have as a nation. But hopefully, I think the government is doing so much in terms of diversifying the economy in the areas that they have been able to diversify their revenue now. We have more people in the tax bracket, like I said. So it's now for them to begin to diversify the economy, having the other sector, the solid mineral sector, the goods and servicing sector. The service sector, especially, that has to do with the digital economy. That is one sector that Nigeria really needs to look at because the world has gone beyond where we are now.
All right. Thank you so very much, Mukhtar Mohammed. We share in your hope and projection that come second quarter of 2021, we'll be out of this. Do stay safe out there.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure.